Introduction to probability. So probability gives us a way of describing mathematically how likely or unlikely an event is, a happening. Probability is a number between 0 and 1, where 0 is impossible and 1 is absolutely definitely going to happen. And halfway between, at 0.5, it's an even chance. Now these can also be given as a fraction, so 0.5, 1, and it can be given as a percentage, 0, 50%, 100%. And they all mean the same thing, but I'm usually quite happy if you give your probability as a fraction. Now we need to cover some terminology, some words that are used with probability, and we'll use this example to cover them. So write down the example, but you don't need to write down this. The letters of the word faith are written on separate cards, so that would look like this, faith, and one is drawn out of a hat at random. What is the probability that it is a vowel? Now we'll answer the question, what's the probability that it is a vowel? But we really want to use this example to talk about the terminology, the words that we use. So the sample space is the first thing you might be asked for. And this is the set of possible outcomes. Now an outcome is any one of the things that can happen. So when you have the letters of faith written on here, I could get an F, an A, an I, a T, or a H. All of those different options are outcomes. Now if I'd picked a word which had two of the same letter, then that would still be two separate outcomes. So if faith happened to have two I's, and there were two I's here, that would be this outcome and the other I. So there's still two outcomes even if they're the same there. So the sample space is the set of possible outcomes. So for this, now we put the sample space in curly brackets and we write all the things we could get separated with commas. So that's the sample space, all the different outcomes. The number of outcomes is just the number of things or elements in the sample space. So the number of outcomes here is 5. Now a trial or an experiment is the experiment that the person did. So that is drawing a letter from a hat at random. Often the trial or the experiment is rolling a die or spinning a spinner or flipping a coin or choosing a number. So this trial or experiment here is the thing that was done. Oh, I switched my colors. The action. So here, that is choosing a card at random. The event is the thing that we're trying to find out about. So the question has the event in it. What is the probability that the letter is a vowel? So the event that we're wondering about The question is about what's the probability of getting a vowel. So the event is getting a vowel. Now the complement of the event is the opposite, not getting the event. So the complement to getting a vowel is not getting a vowel. So when you look at the letters of faith, the vowels are I and A, and everything else is not a vowel, FTH, and so that's the total of the possibilities. The event and its complement covers everything that could happen. It's either a vowel or not a vowel. So that's the complement. Now sometimes you can write getting a vowel for event or even just vowel, and you can call the complement not getting a vowel, or instead of not getting a vowel you can write vowel with a little apostrophe which says not a vowel, but that's a bit technical. So the event getting a vowel and the complement not getting a vowel. And we'll learn more about the complement later on, but we do need to know what complementary events are. It's worth noting that the two probabilities have to add up to one, because there's no other possibilities out there apart from getting a vowel or not getting a vowel. And the probability, of course, is the chance of it happening, of the event happening, as a fraction. So in this one, the number of ways of getting a vowel is 1, 2, and out of the total number of outcomes, that's 2 out of 5. And we'll learn more about the probability as well. So a couple of example questions. We roll a 6-sided die. So what's the sample space? I could get, in curly brackets, a 1, a 2, a 3, a 4, a 5, or a 6. How many outcomes are there? How many things in the sample space? 6. What is the trial? That was the experiment that was done. Rolling a die. How many even number outcomes are there? 1, 2, 3. The probability of getting an even number would be 3 even outcomes out of 6 total possible outcomes, and that simplifies to 1/2. What is the complementary event to even? Not even, or you could say odd. Sorry about the noise outside. Another example. 2 pink buttons, 2 blue buttons, and 1 yellow button. Oh, nope, I got the wrong number of buttons, so I won't have an example. I'll put into a bag and one is pulled out at random. List the sample space. 2 pink, 2 blue, 1 yellow. So the sample space is pink, pink, blue, blue, yellow, because there's 2 different ways of getting a pink one. There's 2 pink buttons in there. The probability of getting a blue button, 2 blue outcomes out of 5 in total, 2 out of 5. The probability of getting a not blue button, not blue, not blue, and not blue, 3 out of 5. But you'll notice it's just whatever's left over. The probability of blue and not blue, 2/5 and 3/5. Find the probability of a purple button, trick question, it's zero because there are no purple buttons in there. We spin a spinner. I've got a spinner here. There we go. Now you'll notice there's two quarters are green, one's red and one's blue. How many equally likely outcomes are there? There's four. Red, blue, this green, and this green. The probability of getting red is one out of a total of four. Probability of getting green is two out of four, which simplifies to 1/2. And the probability of getting not red, if the probability of getting red is 1 out of 4, the probability of getting not red is 3 out of 4. They're complementary events, so they must add up to 1 in total.